Hi, this is Kumaran. Today we will discuss about a traffic light system with 8086. One of the interesting and we are using day-to-day life when we travel on the cities. This is the major problem as we are facing because we will stuck up within the traffic. So in that time, always we will look into it, this system, how it is changing, why it is giving a lot of red time, red signal, then yellow signal, very short of green signal. Everything we will think of it, this is the basic application of an electronic engineer, especially the application of microprocessor. Let's dive into this, how to design a system, what are the backgrounds of the system. With the help of 86 microprocessor, how can you design a system? That's what we will look into this topic. Let's move into the topic. So, from the layman perspective, traffic light means it is a light. It is a LED which will emit a light. That's what everyone can understand. But internally, if we have to glow an LED or to switch off an LED, we need to have the basic knowledge about that particular LED. For example, LED means two terminals, one terminal anode, other terminal is cathode. So the anode terminal, we need to connect a positive of supply. The cathode terminal, we need to connect a ground, which means a negative. So then only the LED will glow. If you are connecting a battery also, the LED may not withstand because the amount of current to an LED is limited. It can allow only a predefined amount of current within it. Suppose you are passing current more than that, it will burn out your LED. So that's what will happen in reality. That's why we are connecting a resistor serially with the LED to limit the current. As you know, the resistor function is to limit the current. It will reduce the amount of current to flow in the circuit through this path. So if the resistance value is more and more, then it will reduce more and more current in this. So that's why we are connecting a resistor with every LED. So let's come to the microprocessor part. Here the microprocessor, we have pin numbers on microprocessor. For example, we will take any one of the pin. We are connecting an LED anode with that. The cathode of the LED is connected to a resistor. Resistor other end is connected to the ground. So at this point, we need to put a logic 1 on this pin, then only the LED will on. If a logic 0 means the circuit will not close, there is no current flow, LED is off. If 1 means circuit closed, then LED is glowing. That's what will happen in this. Such a way, you can connect directly any LED with the microprocessor that can serve the purpose for traffic light. See here, the light which you want to on, whether it is color LEDs, red color, green color or yellow color, that is you can choose the LED. But the microprocessor is concerned whether it has to be on or off. That's the only worry we have to take care about. The color of the LEDs, we can choose different lights. That is out of control of microprocessor. That's it. But we have a drawback here. When we connect LED with the microprocessor directly, the microprocessor has to give data continuously to on. Then whenever it wants to off, it has to produce 0 continuously. So the processor cannot do any other instruction execution while writing the data to the LED. So that's the one of the drawback here. That's why we are introducing one more device. Already we learned about this 8255 programmable peripheral interface. That will act as a mediator between microprocessor and your I/O devices. So in between we will connect this. The processor will inform that you have to switch on the LED, then that 8255 will switch on the LED continuously until the processor tells to switch off the LED. That's what. So after switch on the LED, the processor can execute some other instruction on own. Whenever it has to control again, it will come back to the 8255, will give the instruction. So it is just like a mediator between processor and output devices. Not only output, all input devices also. So let's discuss about the application of LEDs. It's a simple application board which is given by VA Microsystems, which will be used most of the colleges for LED interfacing experiments. So let us look into the system in deeply. We have LEDs, green color, red color, yellow color, and white LEDs. So these are all LEDs available here. The LEDs numbers are given such a way that from D1, so D1, D2, D3, up to that D16, D20. Oh, we have 20 LEDs on this green, yellow, red. So these are 20 LEDs. Then we have DL. DL means these are all dual color LEDs. If the LED can be glown as red as well as green, so the same LED will glown as red as well as yellow. That's the advantage of this dual LED. These LEDs are used for pedestrian crossing. Pedestrian crossing, as the people are walking from one end of the road, it has to cross to the other end of the road. These two LEDs has to be enabled as green. Then the pedestrian can cross across. Such a way in all directions, we have 8 dual LEDs, but 8 LEDs are connected together as 4. Because in a single path, we cannot enable one is red, one is green. There is no meaning on that. So both should be on as a green, or it should be on as a red. So both these two are considered as one LED. Likewise, DL1, DL2 are one, 3, 4, one LED, 4, 5, one LED, 5, 6, and 7, 8 are one LED. So totally we have 28 LEDs in the system. So all these 28 LEDs are connected with the port of 8255. 8255, you know that it has 3 ports, port A, port B, port C. All are 8 bit wide, each 8 bit lines. So each and every port pin of 8255, one LED has been connected. Those LED names are connected in this board based on the hardware architecture. It is connected that D1 to D8 on port A, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, D7, D8. So up to these LEDs are connected on port A. Then port C, D9 to D16. D9 starts here, D9, D10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. So these are all connected with port C. The remaining D17 to 20 connected on upper port B. Then the dual LEDs are connected on lower port B. Such, this is the hardware architecture. Suppose you want to design a system, you need not to follow the same order. You can try any method, but while writing program, you have to follow that which port you have connected such a way through this. That's the only restriction, but it is already constructed. That's why we are following the sequence. Let's come to this functioning of this board. How it is simulated, or how it is assumed that the traffic real time with this. When these lights are not looking same as what we are looking at the real time traffic light signals. This is made for only a demo purpose. So it is one logical assumption. That's what. So it is assumed that the signals, these 5 LEDs are corresponding to the traffic coming from this side. So from south side, people are coming. They have to look at this top left 5 signals. If the red is on, they should not come here. They have to shoot stop with this. That's the right. Then the D20 on means they can come take left. Left is almost a free left nowadays, but as the system says that 20 should be on to keep left. Then the 17 to be go straight on. 16 on means they can take a right. So that's the assumption here. Same way, if the people are coming from north, they have to look at this top left, these 5, same meaning. Red means stop, this 10 means left, then 7 means straight, then 6 means take right. Likewise, from this from east, they can look at this 5 LEDs. From west, they have to look at this 5 LEDs. So that's the default condition based on the hardware. See, in this which direction you want to allow or stop, this is based on real-time requirement. That will give you the application or user will give you the data, which direction you want to give more time, which direction you want to give less time. Everything will be given by the real-time data which is required by the user. That's what you can see in traffic signal also. In the main road, they will give more time to cross the traffic on main road. If sub roads, will give less time because that amount of traffic vehicles will be less on these roads. Such a way it will be there. Then suppose you are allowing pedestrian, you have to enable this dual LEDs as green. So it will on. So it is 0 means on, 1 means off. 1 means red actually. 0 means green, 1 means red. Such a way it will be configured. So what we have to do is, now we need to assign a logical condition. For example, I am assuming that traffics are coming this way. So I have to allow this state, I have to allow this left, I have to allow this right. So in this movement of vehicles, there is no possibility of dual LEDs. The pedestrians cannot cross. So it should be on as a red. So all pedestrians should be on as a red. So now we have to assign data for this. First we will look at this. D20 should be on. So D20 in this sheet, where it is 1 here, right logic 1. Then D17 to be on. D17 is on, make it as 1. 16 to be on, make it as 1. D16 is here, make it as 1. See, in this logical condition, if you are allowing traffic from south to all other directions, we will not enable any other directions. We have to stop all other. So except this red, all red should be on. Then only the people from other side, they should wait. So D13 to be on, make it as logic 1 here. Then here D3 should be on, make it as logic 1 here. Then one more is D8. D8 to be on, make it as 1. Now the red LEDs, 1 means red, 0 means green. That is depends upon the structure. In the structure, it is such a way. Red means 1. All dual LEDs are 1. So make it as 1 here. So these are all the LEDs we have to on. Remaining should be off. So make it 0. All other ratas, make it 0. So this is one condition. This entire data, this is for only one condition. So we have to generate such all possible conditions. Four conditions from all four directions, one condition for pedestrian crossing. Likewise, we can design our system. So what we will do is, we will write this data in terms of hexadecimal. How much this is? 90 for port C. Port B is 9F. The first 4 bits, next 4 bits, like take on 4 bits at a time, find out a X equivalent. This is 84. So this data will differ based on the hardware architecture. For this architecture, it comes like this. If you are exchanging the name of the LED, it will differ. So that's not the issue here based on this. So this is one condition you want to allow from traffic from south to all other directions. Suppose you want to allow from east to all other directions, you have to find one more set of data. Then from north, further another set of data. From east, another set of data. Then the pedestrian crossing, one more set. So 5 conditions we are making, all 5. For one condition, 3 bytes. 5 into 3, 15 bytes of data you have to generate based on our assumed conditions. That's what. In practically, it may have more than this also. So that is depends upon the requirement. But how to design a system, that's what I'm explaining in this. Let's move on to this next one. Take this data. So hardware architecture, how the microprocessor and LEDs are connected. Microprocessor is connected with the 8255 with the data lines, control bus. Then the 8255 is connected, the 8 data lines on 8 LEDs on port A, 8 LEDs on port B, another 8 on port C. Such a way connected. This is the block diagram, you can see. So 8255 has internally a control register and address of port A, port B, port C. So we have 4, 3 ports, 1 control register. Microprocessor can access a control register, access port A, port B, and port C to the microprocessor. See, the address of the port A is 50, port B is 52, port C is 54, control register address is 56. These addresses are fixed here because the such a way the hardware has been connected in this. So based on the predefined interface circuits what we used here. So as a programmer we cannot change it, based on the hardware connection made. Already it is made by the VA microsystem. That's why I am using that address here. So suppose I want whatever the data I have generated for the conditions, I have to place port A, port B, port C on the corresponding data. Then we have to give some time. The time is generated by a delay program. Then we will give the another condition. That's what we will do repeatedly. So the next one is we have to write a control word. The 8255 we have to tell the port A is input or output, ports B, port C, all are which port, which mode of operation. We have mode 0, mode 1, mode 2. Out of these three mode, which mode you want to operate. So for that, this is the control register, 8-bit structure. The first bit is the port C, input means 1, output means 0. See, in our application, we are connecting an LED. You know that the LED is an output device. Simply, we will write data on it. You cannot get any output from LED to the microprocessor. Always from microprocessor to the LED. That's why this is output. So make it this bit as a 0 here. Then D1 is port B. Port B also output port, because all ports we are using as output. Then D2, here the mode is very simple mode. We are using mode 0 because this is a simple IO. So we will select mode 0 here. Then D3 is port C upper. All ports we are using as output, so keep it as 0. Then D4 is port A, that also we are using as output, keep it as 0. Then these two bits are mode selection. This is for 00 mode 0. See, actually here it is exchanged. This is mode 0, this is mode 1. So by wrong, this by mistake it has come. So 00 means mode 0, 01 mode 1, 10 mode 2, 1x. Then this bit, whether we are using IO mode or BSR mode. BSR mode means bit set reset mode, which is applicable only to control port C. In this case, we are using a simple IO because LED is a very simple output device. So we are using as IO mode, keep as 1. So find out hexadecimal number for this. This is 8. Then the remaining 4 zeros, 80. So 80 is a control word. We have to place to the 8255 to configure our system as traffic light output systems. So let's move on to the program now. We generated a data, we generated control register. Now we will move on to this program. See, in this program, see whatever the control word we generated previous slide, that to be loaded into the AL, transferred to the 56. Out 56 comma AL means the content of AL, which is 80, to be loaded to the 56. 56 is the address of the control register. That's what we have seen in the hardware. Control register address is 56. We are moving. So the next thing is whatever data we generated. So 842010, this is for a different condition. Whatever we generated, that data we will write continuously in this memory address. So this is one set, one condition, next condition, next condition. Like how many conditions you want, write data continuously on this memory location. So that address to be loaded with the source index, copy the first data to the AL, moving to the port A. Port A address is 50. So that's the one, say, one data being loaded. Next data move to the 1500 to 1501. Increment the SI, it will point out the next data. Copy this to port B. Then increment once, that to be copied to the port C. Likewise, if we are writing all ports, first we are writing control word, the next we are writing port A, port B, port C. So after assigning one condition, we have to generate a delay because we need to give some time to traffic to move. That's why we are calling a delay program. So after the delay means simply, we will write some register on the data on the register, it will decrement continuously until the register values gets 0, which means we cannot keep as microprocessor idle. It has to execute some instruction, but such a way it has to generate a delay also. So for that purpose we are calling a delay program as a subroutine. It will load that BX100, the 100H, all are hexadecimal. Then the DX with FFFF, we are decrementing DX. No zero means again we are decrementing. So this will repeat FFFF times. So once this reaches zero, we are decrementing BX 99. Again we are loading this, executing. So the inner loop will repeat 100H times, which means 100 hexadecimal times it will repeat the inner loop. So finally, if both the registers are 0, BX and DX are 0, then only it will come out of the loop. It will return to the main program here. So what we are doing, incrementing SI to point out the next one. So again, we are repeating, get the data, placing port A, placing port B, port C, and again calling a delay. So this will repeat indefinitely, continuously. So it will repeat. How long the power is given? That's what the traffic light system will work 24/7 because of the microprocessor will repeat. See, this is a repeatable process. We'll execute. So that's the program for traffic light system. So if it is asked in any examination, you have to draw this very clearly. The first thing is you have to explain about what is how to interface LED with the microprocessor. The simple this diagram is enough with this data. Then you have to draw a sample. This is we have to mention only the pin numbers. That's the important here, not about the shape of the LEDs and all. Put a dot, that's enough to point out. Then we have to generate a data such a way. Then the hardware circuit for microprocessor, this one 8255, then port A, port B, port C. This is the block diagram, and this is the control word for finding 80 control register. Then write the program. That will be enough to score even 15 marks, whatever it is, maximum marks you can score out of it. If you have any doubt, comment on this video, I will clarify it. Thank you for your patience listening.